Hey guys, Jasmine here from Jasmine Baking Studio, and today we're gonna make a mini vanilla cake. If you know me, you probably know that I like to bake mini stuff. You don't have to worry about the amount of sugar you add in, and it's also not a waste of ingredients, especially when you have, like, for example, you only have one egg left. You can make this thingy. Plus, it's just super easy. So without further ado, let's get started.
So to start, you'll need 2 tablespoons of oil along with 2 tablespoons of sugar, white sugar, that's what I'm using, and just mix that all up. Then crack in 1 large egg in room temperature, of course, and mix it all up nice and thoroughly, just like that. Now, 1 tablespoon of milk and 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. You can also use 1/4 teaspoon of vanilla, just like I'm using here. And then just mix it up until it's one uniform color. Now, add in 6 tablespoons of flour and 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. How do you baking powder? And then mix it up until nice and smooth, but do not overmix it. Once you mix it all up together, then you're fine. Something like that. Nice and smooth, but just combine. Then place that into your grease-lined 4-inch pan, round pan I'm using, and then scrape out everything from your bowl into the pan. You don't want to miss any of those goodness. Then, time to bake in the oven for 180 degrees for 25 minutes. And this is how it looks like when it comes out. There's a nice dome shape on top. Then, once it cools down a bit, take out the whatever it's called. And then now you can put it in the fridge. And then put it in the fridge for about 10 minutes or so. That will prevent less crumbs while we are doing our decorating. So just take out the bottom and we're gonna do some decorating. And if you know me, I'm not very good at decorating, but I have 5 tips for you to do an awesome decorating job without any special tools. Number 1, cut your cake with a serrated knife, sawing motion, and then flip it around so the flat sides top. Then spread out whatever spread or icing you want. I like to use spread because it does not, like, you don't need to break out your electric mixer. Anyways, this cake is so good together with Nutella, so that's why I'm using Nutella today. Smooth out the sides. And then we're gonna go with tip number 2, and tip number 2 is to make indents like what I'm doing here. I am doing circular strokes, and it does look like I'm drawing an egg. But what I like to do is go in a circular spiral motion because that one looks nicer to me. Now, tip number 3 is really important. You always need your sprinkles. It can be festive sprinkles, satin sprinkles, rainbow sprinkles, anything's fine. I'm using heart sprinkles because it's not Valentine's Day, but I like to do it anyways. And then I place this little cute umbrella just for more festive look. Now, tip number 4 is to use candy or chocolate buttons to decorate your cake because it does give a nice flavor. I'm using white chocolate buttons because white chocolate and Nutella complements itself, just making this totally awesome. Tip number 5 is to make a simple frosting or glaze. And this is a simple frosting or glaze recipe. It's just sugar, icing sugar, and water. And then those are mixed up all together. And so if you want like a thicker glaze, like an icing-like glaze, use more powdered sugar. But if you want like a thinner glaze, like the glaze, then obviously use more water. Something like this is something that I like, and I'm gonna use this. So that's somewhere in between. I just place it in a piping bag and I'll frost it all together, but you can also use anything else you like, different method, thicker stuff. And here you go, this is what we have here.
Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe to this channel and give this video a big thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. So bye.